Good afternoon, everyone, honorable chair, presenters, and the audience. First of all, I must say that I feel privileged to present my first research paper in front of an expertise in space law, Professor Reddy. My research topic is also relevant to space law. My research topic is a critical analysis of the Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty and its relevance for the present day. The outline of my research is, firstly, I have to introduce the research area, research problem, research objectives, methodology, and then I have to discuss about space weapons, and then inadequacy of the Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty, recommendations, and finally, the conclusion. Space law can be defined as the body of law that governs space-related activities. When you look at space law, the mother treaty or the primary treaty governing space activities is the Treaty on Principles Governing the Activities of States in the Exploration and Use of Outer Space, including the Moon and other celestial bodies, or more commonly known as the Outer Space Treaty of 1967. There are 17 articles in this treaty, and if you look at these 17 articles, the main objective of the treaty is to guarantee peaceful uses of outer space. And also, the preamble of the treaty also recognizes the common interest of all states to explore and use outer space exclusively for peaceful purposes. Therefore, this outer space treaty can be recognized as one of the significant arms control development. In all these 17 articles, when you look at Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty, you can argue, you can see that the essence of the Outer Space Treaty is in Article 4. It states that state parties to the treaty undertake not to place in orbit around the Earth any objects carrying nuclear weapons or any other weapons of mass destruction. Further, it states that Moon and other celestial bodies shall be used exclusively for peaceful purposes. Therefore, it is clear that the very objective of Outer Space Treaty to guarantee peaceful uses of outer space is there in this Article 4. And you can see that Article 4 restricts military activities in two ways. Firstly, it contains an undertaking not to place in orbit around the Earth any objects carrying nuclear weapons or other weapons of mass destruction. Secondly, it restricts the use of Moon and other celestial bodies exclusively for peaceful purposes. My research problem is whether Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty prohibits modern day space weapons such as kinetic kill vehicles, anti-satellites, and space-based lasers. And my research objective are to examine Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty, to analyze its adequacy to include modern space weapons, and to propose necessary changes to Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty. Basically, I have used primary and secondary sources. Primary sources including treaties, domestic space legislation, secondary sources including books, journal articles, online articles, treaties, treatises, annual reports, and I've done a field research also. When you think of modern day space weapons, basically you can divide space weapons into two broad categories, kinetic kill vehicles and directed energy weapons. I will not be discussing the structure or the technologies used in these deep space weapons because that is not relevant to law, but basically they are solid objects designed to crash into their targets. And because of the extreme velocities of objects traveling in orbit, no explosives are needed. They are very powerful space weapons. And there is evidence that USA, America has had anti-satellites since 1980s. And when you look at National Space Policy of United States of America, published in 2006, it is clear that USA has invested a significant amount of money in their space program, especially in developing anti-satellites. And also, China tested an anti-satellite weapon in 2007. But both these countries are parties to the Outer Space Treaty. Not only these two countries, but there are other countries also who are testing and using space weapons. Therefore, the question comes, although they are parties to the Outer Space Treaty, although the very objective of the Outer Space Treaty is to guarantee peaceful uses of outer space, how can they use these new space weapons? Whether these space weapons are prohibited in Article 4. Now, as I discussed earlier, Article 4 of the treaty bans stationing of objects carrying nuclear weapons and other weapons of mass destruction. But Article 4 has not expressly stated about these new space weapons, such as kinetic kill vehicles, anti-satellite and directed energy weapons. So, and also, another loophole is the term space weapons and weapons of mass destruction is not defined. Therefore, the question comes, what comes under the category of space weapons and what comes under the category of weapons of mass destruction? And also, as a proper definition is not provided in the Outer Space Treaty of 1967, states may interpret it in different ways for their advantage. Therefore, it is clear that although Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty bans nuclear objects and other objects carrying other objects of mass destruction on outer space, it does not clearly state about these new space weapons. And also the definitions of space weapons and weapons of mass destruction are not given. Therefore, it is clear that a major loophole is there in Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty. But when you look at from 1967 up and up to this year, to 2016, United Nations General Assembly has taken several steps to guarantee peaceful uses of outer space. Every year, General Assembly has passed resolutions calling for peaceful uses of outer space. In 2000 also, a resolution was passed titled Prevention of Outer Space in Arms, Outer Space Arms Race. And also, Russia and China presented a draft paper to the United Nations Conference on Disarmament, which contained possible elements of an international legal agreement on prohibiting the deployment of any weapons in outer space. That draft paper also prohibits using any space weapons in outer space. And in last year, another resolution was passed banning arms race in outer space. But USA, being one of the major spacefaring nations, objected to this, voted against this. Therefore, you can argue mainly in two ways. Firstly, if major spacefaring nations, if states who are testing and using space weapons objected to these subsequent measures, then the peaceful uses of outer space is not guaranteed. Then these subsequent measures are not successful. And secondly, resolutions are considered as soft law. Therefore, the binding force of the resolution is lower than treaty provisions. Therefore, it is important that we include these space weapons, new space weapons, in the treaty provision. And also, if we can include these new space weapons in Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty, then states would adhere to that. And also, I would like to conclude by saying that Outer Space Treaty, although it is one of the significant lawmaking treaties in outer space, it contains a major loophole in Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty. And also, critics have suggested that if we let these countries use and test space weapons in outer space, it would lead to another arms race. That is a problem to world peace. And also, outer space is considered as a common heritage of mankind. According to this principle of common heritage of mankind, outer space cannot be owned by any state. No state can exercise their sovereignty in outer space. It belongs to everyone. But if we let the developed states, especially to use new space weapons, then the principle of common heritage of mankind is also violated. And also, Article 4 can be described as a partial disarmament approach. But when you look at all 17 articles in the Outer Space Treaty, it aims at peaceful uses of outer space. Therefore, it is of paramount importance to update Article 4 of the Outer Space Treaty to include modern-day space weapons. Thank you.